God speak in our hearts, in our minds, and through our mouths. Amen.
Amen.
So Jesus used a lot of different imagery to speak and teach. One of the best are when he talks about the lives of shepherds and using images of shepherding people. People who farm the sea, fishermen primarily, but using those images, speaking to people in ways about the kingdom of heaven, in images that they would understand. He spoke a lot about farming, spoke a lot about plants, the parable of the mustard seed, talks about the parable of the tree that needed to be tended. Today we have the saying from the Gospel of John about a vine. The thing with vines, as Jesus says quite clearly and very simply, he says, I am the vine, you are the branches. As he's explaining, talking about branches breaking off, no longer having life, he's making the point that the body of Christ, that the church, is not just like those branches, but is in fact like the vine. In other translations of this text, we find slightly different variations and slightly different perspective on looking at the vines and the branches being cut off. And some of you get the sense that, you know, you wouldn't want to be one of those branches that was not producing fruits and to get cut off. So perhaps over the years in some different sermons, you've been left feeling with that sense of fear that, you know, whatever I do, I want to make sure that I'm one of those branches that's producing fruit, lest you get cut off and then you wither and dry up, and then all you're good for is fuel for the fire. And Jesus challenged people all over the place. But this is not one of those images that I think he was using to challenge people in that way. There's something about talking about the vine and the branches that is obviously organic. It's a plant. It's a living thing. We're very good at talking about the church as an institution. But the church is also a living, breathing organism. The idea of a branch, a branch that produces fruits, means that it is absolutely reliant on the vine. And that the vine, at some point, is connected to a root system, and it's grounded. Jesus was the incarnate God. Sometimes we say the incarnate Son of God. Jews understood David, King David, as the Son of God. But David had died. Jesus was alive. We, as the church, hold today that Jesus is still alive. And so thinking of vines and plants that continue to live generation after generation gives us a sense of the depth of the image that Jesus was using, talking about the vine and the branches. And yes, branches produce fruit, but they don't do it on their own. The branches are connected to the vine, and the vine is connected to roots. So if we are the branches, as Jesus said, he is the vine, and God is the whole. God is the whole plant. And so the effort of producing fruit is not ours and ours alone, because a branch that is cut off and is withered and dried up cannot produce fruit. The branch can only produce fruit when it's connected to the vine, and when that's connected to a healthy root system, and when there is life flowing through it. So if we look at this image of the vine and the branches as an image of the church, as an image of the body of Christ, then the fruit of the work of the church is God in and through us, we look to politics, if we look to popular culture, we hold on very closely to this myth of the self-made person, or to use the more gender-specific language, the self-made man. That somehow we are responsible for everything, that we are the masters of our own destiny. This image of the branch connected to the vine gives us a different sense. A sense of the power of God working in and through creation. And to see ourselves as part of creation and not part of an institution. And there's some other places in scripture, in the letter to Paul, where it talks about us being grafted. Now, for this is, I will admit, the extent and the limit of my knowledge of gardening, but when you cut a branch off on purpose, and you very carefully take care of it, then you can graft it onto something else. Or if you're even more careful, you can take it and very carefully care for it and turn it into a whole new plant. Now, my limited understanding, you can't do that with every kind of plant that has branches, but you can do it with some. But this idea that we have been grafted onto the vine, it goes along with Paul's imagery of us being adopted into the family of God. And so think about the vine of God, the vine that represents the whole body, the church. A lot of different branches bearing a lot of different kinds of fruit grafted into one amazingly, perhaps, depending on the way you look at it, monstrous, almost, plant. And yet in that is the chaos of life and the beauty of life. So this simple image from John of the vine and the branches, when, I don't know about you, but I often find John can be a little confusing in his writing, and you get twisted up in the words and you're following through and you feel like you're back where you started, but you're not sure how you got there. There's this brilliantly simple image that is so deep and has so much meaning. I am the vine, and you are the branches. If you abide in me, I will abide in you. And if we truly are branches of the vine, then it can't be anything but God abiding in us and us abiding in God. We are connected. This organic image reminds us that the church is a living, breathing entity and not just an institution. It gives us life, and it gives us a sense of rooted and groundedness. It gives us a sense of connection one to the other, and an appreciation of all the different branches that have been grafted onto this vine, producing some of the most amazing fruit that the world has ever seen. So as we share in the Eucharist this evening, and as you're sent out, think of God working in and through you. Think of the amazing vine, the amazing plant that you are connected to. Think about the opportunity for God to work through you and to produce fruit that you never even thought possible that you would be able to. This is the unstoppable, amazing, miraculous power of life that continues and carries on through every situation, in every age, and in every time. For this, we give thanks.